All it takes is one drive around any of California's cities, one drive through an underpass or by a deserted street corner to see that we're in the throes of an undeniable housing crisis. You can't turn away from it. It's everywhere you go. A crisis that touches every corner and every community in the state, including the city of Elk Grove. A crisis that will only worsen unless all of us work in unison, together, doing our part, pitching in. Each and every one of us, from state office to city council, has a role, even a duty, to check our egos and put our fellow Californians first. Unfortunately, we're here because Elk Grove has shirked that responsibility. Instead, they've chosen to stifle affordable housing projects, discriminate against lower-income families, and knowingly violate state housing law. That's why I, alongside Governor Newsom and HCD, am announcing a lawsuit to require Elk Grove to approve the Oak Rose Supportive Housing Project and fall in line with the law. If approved, Oak Rose would create 66 units of supportive housing for lower-income folks at risk of homelessness in an area in dire need of lower-income housing. Looking at the evidence, it's clear this project was denied because of the intended residents. Because while Oak Rose was denied under the guise of an quote-unquote objective standard, that housing project must only have commercial space, that housing project must only have commercial space on the ground floor, that was the articulated reason, a market-rate housing development subject to the same standard included residential space on the ground floor, and yet was recently approved in the same area. So one project for lower income folks with supportive housing denied, the same approach in a more market rate project, less housing for higher income housing approved. That's wrong. Can't do that. Not such an objective standard after all, if it only applies to one project and not the other. They're clearly exercising discretion in a discriminatory way. The main difference between the two projects is that one creates fewer homes at a higher price, the other creates more homes that are more affordable. In fact, Elk Grove even admitted that its, quote, objective standard isn't really objective, which means they can't use it to deny the project. Elk Grove's decision to deny the Oak Rose project violates multiple state laws, SB 35, the Housing Accountability Act, and California's fair housing laws. Laws specifically in place to address our critical housing needs, combat discrimination, and increase affordable housing opportunities. And again, these are laws, they're not optional. They're required, they're mandatory. You must follow them. The law is the law. It applies to everyone equally. Every Californian has plenty of opportunities to engage in the lawmaking process. But this isn't one of them. This is after the lawmaking process is over and the laws are codified in our state statutes. If you want to, while laws are being proposed and amended and determined and finally decided, you can advocate against legislation if you don't like it. You can call, you can email, you can tweet the governor not to sign the bill if that's what you wish. You can challenge a law in court. You can even run for office to do your part in a publicly elected official role. But you can't ignore a law once it's in place, simply because it doesn't suit you. The laws are clear, and this legislature and this governor are becoming more and more impatient about the need to build more housing across the state. The laws reflect that. They provide clear requirements for expedition of the production of housing, streamlining of the production of housing, more ministerial review, and those laws are clear, as is Elk Grove's refusal to follow those laws. The message we're sending today is clear as well. Act in good faith, follow the law, do your part to address California's housing crisis. If you don't, we will be there to hold you account. For 2 years, DOJ's housing strike force has been monitoring compliance and ramping up enforcement where laws have been broken. We've taken action in multiple cities across the state, as you may have seen, Huntington Beach, Pasadena, Woodside, Encinitas, El Cajon, are just some examples, as well as other local jurisdictions, and we're not losing steam, not even close. We're speeding up. We're going to continue to do more if the actions of local jurisdictions require it. But again, act in good faith, follow the law, do your part to address California's housing crisis. We're not going to lose steam, not when, according to HCD, California will need an estimated 2.5 million new homes by 2030 in order to meet housing demand. And yet less than 125,000 new homes are being built each year. The dearth of housing is driving up prices across the state, making our unaffordability crisis worse. Meanwhile, every night, an estimated 170,000 Californians, they sleep in shelters or on the street. This is the challenge California is confronting. We can't avert our gaze. We can't look away. We can't get distracted. We've all got to be committed to tackling this problem, to confronting it. You have to face the problem before you can fix the problem. Everyone has a role to play. Everyone has a part that they can do. So that's what we're doing today. We're making sure that those who have a role are following that role, not shirking it, not violating the law, not flouting the law. This isn't an easy problem. It's not going to be solved overnight. Everyone here knows that. But if we all pitch in, if we all do our part together, we can solve it. If each of us are committed to using all the tools at our disposal to advance housing access, housing affordability, and equity in California, we can get there together. We're committed to ensuring no one is above the law and no one is discriminated against because of how much money they make.